No, I'm telling you, you got to stop it. The broadcasting, it's a matter of life and death. Please, stop it, 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 stop it! Hey, what's going on, folks, and welcome to another Reputized video! Halloween 3, Season of the Witch, stars Tom Atkins, Stacey Nelkin, and Dan O'Hurley. I hope I'm pronouncing his name right, God rest his soul. It's all about this evil warlock, played by Hurley, who plots to kill all the children in America by selling them these cursed masks that apparently changes when you watch a TV screen with a flashing pumpkin on it. This one, unfortunately, as I just gave with the plot description, does not feature Michael Myers. It focuses more on the Halloween season, hence the name Season of the Witch. But yeah, this evil warlock played by O'Hurley, he's diabolical, he's sinister, he's really menacing. This is the only movie I've seen that actor play in, but he played it really well. Tom Atkins plays Challis, a doctor, who goes to this town with this girl trying to help her find what happened to her father. Stacey Nelkin plays Ellie Grimbrit, the daughter of the man who got killed at the beginning, who tries to find out what happened, where exactly her dad was going, and what he was doing. It was a pretty interesting movie for what it was. I'm not going to degrade it completely. Michael Myers is the symbol for that franchise. But John Carpenter and Deborah Hill had it all in their minds to want to start fresh. They were wanting to do an anthology series. This one was going to be about the witches. The next one was going to be about something else of the Halloween tradition. And then the next one was going to be something completely different. It was going to be different stories. But the box office for this one pretty much opened the studio's eyes and forced Carpenter not to want to return anymore until this new Halloween movie is getting ready to come out, obviously. The director, Tommy Lee Wallace, gave it a pretty good run. It was directed pretty good. The cinematography and the lighting was good. Dean Cundey returned to do the cinematography in this one. So, of course, it looked pretty good, just like the last two. The editing was done well. It wasn't too choppy. It wasn't too fast. Like I said, the direction was straightforward. You understood what was going on. It was just another one of those genocide-type movies where the villain plots to kill all the children in the world, the youth of America, pretty much, by setting bombs in TVs, but not in the same sense. All right, the music in this one, like the last one, it had a thicker sense to it, and it was a synth sound, synthesizing sound. I hope I'm saying that right. Forgive me, folks. But in this movie, it was more to it than that. It was much thicker. There was more of a synth sound to it. John Carpenter and Alan Howarth did the score to this one as well, like they did with the first two. It's not one of my favorites. You know, I still think the second one was one of my most favorite scores out of the entire series. But this one was more synthetic, I guess you could say. But it was fair for what the movie was trying to be. The pros, this movie was more about the season, the festive of Samhain, all things Halloween. The cons, however, it's not that memorable. After being introduced to such an iconic character like Michael Myers, of course nothing else is going to work. And that's what John Carpenter and Deborah Hill was hoping for this one. They were wanting to follow an anthology series just solely about the season, and that was it. But the audience has already gotten adapted to Michael Myers. The damage was already done. So the box office returns pretty much showed the studio, people don't care about this. They care more about a guy in a white mask stalking people, pretty much. So that being said, that kind of ruined John Carpenter's plans and I guess pissed him off or something, because he wanted nothing to do with him after that. Michael's absence didn't really help. But it was still a good movie. Halloween 3, Season of the Witch, is still a good movie for what it was. It was all about the season. It was all about Halloween. More traditional. My final thoughts of it, it wasn't the best, but it was good. It was a good Halloween movie. You know, if you were to take the Halloween 3 title out and just name it Season of the Witch, then that probably would have made more sense to people. And it probably would have made a little more back from the box office. And naming it Halloween 3 Season of the Witch, I'm pretty sure a lot of people back in 1982, which is when this came out, felt cheated. I wouldn't doubt for a second that people felt cheated during this. But again, I liked it. It wasn't the best, but it was good for what it was. I'm going to give Halloween 3 Season of the Witch a C+. Stay tuned for my review for Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers, coming soon. Hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. Like, subscribe, and get reputized. Share, even. Peace the Rip out.